If you are into crypto, you should know how bridges are critical for our crypto investment. Moving our assets between our favorite chains is something most of us do every day. I'm here to show you how to be eligible for two potential airdrops while you move your assets. Yes, it's worth watching this video if you don't want to miss any airdrop because you didn't complete some critical tasks. Some random tasks won't make you eligible for a hefty airdrop. Learn how to be a hunter. Remember, we are not your financial advisor, and this is not a financial advice. Everything in this video is intended as educational material only. Hello, my name is Mo and I'm the voice of Unbox Block. Here are my 10 airdrop hunting rules.
10 hunter rules.
Do not get greedy and never farm with multiple wallets. Do not make microtransactions. Repeat the process if you don't have much funds to do that. Be a genuine user and use the products when you get a chance between tasks. Do not do the same transaction over and over. Always change pairs. Hold assets on multiple chains in your wallet. Never use your main wallet to test a new product or hunt airdrop. Complete and verify your DeBank profile and mint the Galax passport. Always support the projects in your way. Leave feedback on the project's social networks. Stay safe and secure, and watch out for fake Discord bots.
Be a hunter, not a prey.
And last but not least, always double check the links. Revoke the contract access and disconnect your wallet from the platform once in a while. Never share your seed or private key with anyone. Now, let's go hunt. This video will demonstrate how you can be eligible for two airdrops. One is Orbiter Finance and the next will be Via Protocol. Even if you are familiar with these platforms, you should double check our list to take advantage of some critical steps. Now it's time to unbox their blocks. Orbiter Finance. Orbiter Finance is a decentralized cross-rollup bridge for transferring the Ethereumnative assets, which is the infrastructure of Layer 2. It offers low-cost and almost instant transfers. Orbiter supports cross-rollup transfers between Ethereum, Starknet, ZK-Sync, Loopring, Arbitrum Nova, Optimism, Polygon, and more. Orbiter supports high-frequency cross-rollup transactions optimistically, so it can be cheap and fast enough to support more cross-rollup user cases in the long term. If you have already tested Orbiter app and viewed the transaction log on the Block Explorer, you will find you've sent funds to a maker's EOA address and not to a contract's address. That's the remarkable difference between Orbiter and other bridge protocols. Orbiter's fee consists of trading fee and withholding fee. Trading fee. Fees paid to the platform and maker that are charged as a percentage of the transfer amount. Withholding fee. The fee prepaid to maker to pay the gas fee for the destination network transfer. Here is the good news. Orbiter Finance confirmed their airdrop, but glad to say that no snapshot has been taken yet. Here is my recommendation to be on the safe side. Do the highest number of transactions possible for you. Orbiter Finance has some impressive Discord roles on their server. Based on the Orbiter Guild page, you can obtain a much appreciated role with a higher number of transactions. Undoubtedly, you will be appreciated by a more significant portion of the airdrop if you can reach the highest role. Let me mention the Orbiter Maker. Later, you will be able to provide liquidity for L2 and benefit from it. I'll also do it to ensure I'll be on the airdrop list, so keep an eye on the Maker tab. Use Orbiter to bridge your testnet tokens to other testnet chains, for example, from Arbitrum Gorley to Teiko. Doing the testnet transaction won't make you eligible for an airdrop, but it may help. Donate to Orbiter on the upcoming Gitcoin grants. Join the Orbiter Discord and be active over there. Now, let's move to Via Protocol. It's time to unbox Via. Cross-chain routing. Via Router aggregates more routers, bridges, and chains than any other cross-chain router to ensure users can find the most efficient secure routes with the most liquidity and cheapest fees to swap their tokens across chains. Via said, "We don't want to get 2 or 3DEXs and a few bridges when we talk about the best router. Instead, we want to know all the possible options for transferring token A on chain X to token B on chain Y. That's why we created our Via Router. Aggregating more DEXs, bridges, and chains than any other project, to ensure users can find the best routes with the most liquidity and cheapest fees to swap their tokens across chains. Here is my recommendation to be on the safe side. Via Protocol had several campaigns in the past but recently announced another one. Try to gain as much of a higher level of NFT as possible. It may become essential later. Buy Via Early Users NFT if you don't have one. bridge, and swap multiple times on different chains and tokens. Both the number and amount of transactions are essential. Repeating some weekly transactions is highly recommended. I'll primarily use the Arbitrum chain to pay less gas fees and be eligible for Arbitrum airdrop. Be smart. Use the refuel function to bridge some gas fees. If you are out of gas on any chain and need some, use refuel to transfer the small amount as a gas fee. Do the crew 3 tasks. Nominate Via to be product of the year on the Product Hunt website. Mark as I use this and leave a review for them. Donate to Via protocol on Gitcoin when a grant is available. Be active in their Discord. Now here is my instructed strategy to use the most efficient routes. If you enjoy this kind of content and don't want to miss any upcoming airdrops, then it's time to follow us on Twitter and Leinster. Do not forget to like and subscribe. Go to via.exchange and bridge Ethereum from Arbitrum to get the USDC on Optimism. Now use the Orbiter to bridge your USDC from Optimism to Matic on Polygon. For the third bridge, use Via protocol to bridge Matic on Polygon to USDT on Avalanche. Now you understand how it works. Repeat the same strategy at least several times by considering your budget. It's highly recommended to use Layer 2 chains to avoid paying high gas fees. Now is your turn to mention what other steps we should add to our list. Comment below to help other members. The video description provides all the links and details you may need. Be careful, do not click on any suspicious links in the comments section. If you are still watching, you probably know what you should know. Remember to like and subscribe and click on the bell if you don't want to miss the next airdrop. Remember us. My name is Mo and this is Unbox Block.